Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Why No One Plays. Today we're going to be talking about Quinn, Demacia's wings. I put this woman in the voting polls 5 times, and every single time she was the lowest or second lowest voted option, which I find kind of funny because she's York and Trundle levels of unpopular. So I decided to finally give Quinn mains some justice by talking about her. Speaking of Quinn mains, just a quick disclaimer, this is not meant to be a personal attack. If you're joining me for the first time, Why No One Plays is a series that talks about unpopular champions and why they're not very appealing to pick up by the general player base. The overall goal is to hopefully give them a little more exposure so maybe people might consider picking her up. Though I feel like I might be angering quite a few top mains by making this one. Whatever, I've already made a video on Kennen, Heimerdinger, and Tahm Kench, so I'm this far in, might as well just see it all the way through. For how diverse the game is in terms of classes and subclasses, League also has a rather rigid boundary of constraint when it comes to subroles. We have the main classes like Fighter, Mage, Tank, etc., and then subclasses like Juggernaut, Artillery, and Wardens, but there aren't a lot of champions in the game who have different jobs, so to speak. In a lot of games, especially real-time strategy or card games, they usually allow you to employ ancillary units to handle niche purposes or serve as counters to certain things. For instance, in Yu-Gi-Oh, you run into a group of cards known as Floodgates, which prevent your opponent from being able to advance the game state through a specific method. A good example would be Vanity's Emptiness, which prevents either player from being able to special summon monsters. It's such a powerful card that it's actually currently banned in tournaments. We would see other auxiliary units in games like Scouts, which don't exactly participate in active combat. Rather, they serve to acquire information, conduct surveillance, and intercept enemy communications. In League of Legends, there's only one champion in the game whose entire playstyle is designed this way, Quinn. She's the only champion whose primary focus is that of a scout. I suppose you could make the argument that all supports are scouts since they put down wards for vision, and maybe you can point out that Malphite is a tank who specializes in countering melee auto-attackers. I understand that, but those are side attributes to their design and not the focal point, if that makes sense. Though her primary method of dealing damage is through ranged auto-attacks, you don't really consider to be an AD carry the way you would Caitlyn, Ashe, or Ezreal. She's also really fast and mobile, able to travel through the map at a speed almost no one else can match, and she's got a lot of good tools you would love to see on a skirmisher, but you don't really put her in the same field as Fiora, Jax, and Riven. Quinn is a specialist, and specialists were originally called zone controllers or zoners, which would probably be the farthest League is willing to go with their wildcard roles, and for the longest time ever, she's been a very solid top laner if we go by win rate, consistently holding around 52-53%. That would ordinarily be grounds for nerfs, but if you then take a look at her play rate history, she's been hard stuck 2% pick rate for most of her existence in the past 6 years. In a lot of Why No One Plays episodes, often what attributes to a champion's low popularity is usually a mixture of an uncomfortable playstyle or underwhelming performance. Quinn is most certainly not a weak champion, not if she's maintaining over a 52% win rate in top lane. So, what is the cause of her low pick rate? The main answer to why no one plays her can be described as such. Quinn has to win games the normal way, but can't play games the normal way. Allow me to repeat, she has to win games the normal way without playing the normal way. If you're still confused, and I don't blame you, Quinn's defining traits are her extremely high tempo and roaming potential, as well as her scouting. Like most scout type units in other games, she's not exactly built for head-on confrontation, and can be easily squashed in teamfights or skirmishes against actual combative champions, which makes up the entire rest of the cast besides her. She's not the first champion I've covered who requires you to play the game in a way no one else does. However, while Singe, Tryndamere, and Teemo allow you to fully understand a different objective, you have to still play the mid-game and late-game just like you were any other top laner, except you have a completely different set of tools. Split pushing is definitely an option for her, as so long as she knows enemies are rotating to stop her, she can hop on Valor and be gone before they even take 3 steps. But she doesn't take towers down very quickly, her wave clear is not the best, and her late game dueling power, while not terrible, isn't on the same level as actual 1v1 duelists. To play her optimally in 5v5 settings, you need to look for flanks. Thanks to her ultimate, she can easily circle around for better angles to approach from without taking too long, and she has enough burst damage to effectively assassinate and outduel most AD carries and mages, due in part to her Q Blinding Assault, which nearsights the first enemy struck just like Graves' smokescreen. This means you can't see her, which also means you can't click on her or even aim at her, while she can get 2 or 3 extra hits in on you. And given that she builds full crit or lethality, that's more than enough to get you out of the fight right away. Because she's so good at roaming around the map, and it's practically impossible for a good Quinn to face check due to heightened senses, the enemy team needs to be extra careful when walking throughout the jungle, because if, say, the Orianna is working on blue buff all by herself, Quinn can zoom around, catch her out, and her team will be none the wiser to it. True to her role as a scout, her best chance at carrying her team is by picking people off one by one and ideally avoiding a head-on full-blown teamfight. Again, she's not useless and can still sort of play front to back since she is still a ranged auto attacker, but usually the ideal scenario is to fly behind enemy lines and eliminate their highest threat, or prevent them from even being in a position to teamfight by assassinating one person at a time. Therein lies another issue though. Quinn's fast in tempo, but not mobility. Unlike assassins, she can't jump in, one-shot a squishy in half a second, then get out. If the enemy bot laner is protected by a big hulking Nautilus or Thresh, you have to be extremely patient with when you engage. She doesn't have a get-out-of-jail-free card in her kit, no stealth, no on-target ability, none of that, and is primarily single target. Quinn's unique style of carrying games also comes with a heavy cost. Given her nature as a hybrid between marksman and skirmisher, any game you pick her will cause an imbalance in your team's composition. You'll always have two ranged auto attackers on your team or two marksmen, provided your bot lane doesn't elect to pick a mage. Team compositions may not matter in the grand scheme of things, the strength of a weapon lies in its wielder. As I mentioned before in my fighters video, it's entirely possible for a team of 5 enchanter supports to beat a legitimate top jungle mid ADC in support, but usually that would require the 5 supports team to have vastly better players than the actual team. In a game of 10 equally skilled players, team composition does matter. A gang of assassins will be destroyed 10 out of 10 times against a hard 5v5 comp with better crowd control, better AoE damage, and better protection. Most top laners are expected to serve as pressure magnets. Fighters, skirmishers, and tanks are all very good at forcing the enemy team to pay attention to them first and foremost. This in turn prevents the mid and bot laners from not being focused down because they don't want to be. Selecting Quinn means your team is without that very crucial piece of the puzzle. I'm not saying you can't build a good team composition with 2 AD carries, but your options are certainly a lot more limited. Moreover, it makes things really easy for the enemy team to draft an effective counter, especially if you're blind picking. Quinn is super good at making bruisers and skirmishers' life a living hell. She counters Renekton, Fiora, Mordekaiser, Riven, etc., but gets completely dumpstered by Malphite, Irelia, Vladimir, Ornn, and a bunch of tanks because she has no sustain and is super squishy. Since mistakes on her can be punished very easily, along with the fact that she struggles to come back from behind, she needs really good matchup knowledge in lane. However, since top lane doesn't have too many ranged AD champions, you can't use fundamentals to flatten the learning curve like you can if you're a Sion one trick and you're picking up Cho'Gath. In other words, you have to relearn top lane all over again through the lens of Quinn. Then, as you transition into the mid to late game, you have to abandon all fundamentals and habits for other champions and develop a whole new set for her and only her, despite still having to be with your team for 5v5s and stuff. Now just an interjection, this is also why Tyler 1 plays really gimmicky champions, Heimerdinger, Ivern, and Quinn. He's used to playing that wildcard playstyle, and also he's built different. The people who play Quinn are also really good at her. Once you figure out your purpose as Quinn, you can pull off a lot of cool stuff and enable her team to do more things. It's trade-off. You do open up your team to some deficiencies in teamfights with a lack of a potential frontline, but you also open up some new strategies. Even though she can't absorb pressure through direct confrontation the way melee top laners can, she can still scare the enemy team into not wandering too far out of lane or in the jungle, especially when she's really fed. While we're on that, this leads us to problem number 3. Top lane, as you know, isn't exactly known for encouraging and fostering proactivity among its players. Quinn has to roam in order to contribute more pressure, because if she stays in the top lane all game, she's only half a champion. Even though her kit practically begs you to roam and be proactive on the map, most top laners just really don't appreciate or even care about the impact roaming has. We do have Shen, but he doesn't really roam per se, he's more of a, oh crap, my ADC's dying, I need to press R on them. As a top laner myself, I think I can very confidently say that top laners have arguably the worst map awareness out of all roles, and that's saying a lot considering how blind most AD carry mains are, let me tell ya. I'm sure at one point or another, every top main has entertained the thought of playing Quinn. They picked her up for one game, go 3-0 in lane against an easy matchup, but then proceed to fumble the mid to late game and complain the champion sucks. She just doesn't embody the type of mindset other champions foster in the top lane. The usual autopiloting for the rest of the cast up there consists of AFK farming for 10 to 20 minutes and then clapping cheeks in the mid game where they can usually one-shot the mid or ADC. And to go even further on her not fitting the mold up there, how do I put it? She's kind of, well, let's just say, top laners are very proud people. And no, I'm not just talking about the fact that their egos are bigger than their brains. This may sound incredibly petty, but if there's one sentiment shared among the vast majority of top laners is how much they hate ranged champions. As you know, top lane features mostly melee champions, and those melee champions often have poor mobility. Compound that with ranged top laners usually having an easy escape, in which case Quinn's Vault may be one of the best anti-melee abilities in the game, and they're disliked greatly not just by their fellow top laners, but potentially their own team. Aside from maybe Gnar, ranged top laners are generally very selfish and can be practically useless for the entire game if they fall behind. Since those who don't play ranged top lanes too often don't know how to utilize them to their fullest extent in the mid to late game, they just pick them to have an easy laning phase. Ranged vs melee is just ranged abusing the crap out of melee until melee runs out of patience and decides to all in. I normally look for strictly gameplay reasons why no one plays a certain champion, but her design actually makes perfect sense for a scout or recon type character. It's just when you translate it to League of Legends, which doesn't have a real place for collecting information, she just evolves into mostly a cheese top laner. As childish as it sounds, outside of her very unorthodox playstyle, she carries a very major stigma. Many players gravitate towards top lane for being that solo 1v9 raid boss. That's why the most popular champions are Darius, Renekton, Sett, Riven, Jax, Wukong. These people want to go in, skulking around the map for easy targets to pick off rather than causing a big scene in teamfights just isn't their style. That's not only in solo queue but in pro play. Top laners need to be that giant pressure magnet, that's the expectation for us there. And so over time that's how the culture formed in the top lane. Problem is, Quinn just can't really fit into any other role. She can't jungle because her clear speed and sustain are trash. She can't go into the mid lane because mages can outrange her and assassins one-shot her. She can't go AD carry because she doesn't really have the same kind of, you know, scaling late game DPS, and support of course is out of the question. It would make a lot more sense for her to be a jungler in my opinion, she's a literal scout. It's honestly a shame for her to be in the top lane because 1, she doesn't really fit in as a top laner, and 2, top lane doesn't really do her role enough justice, it's just that she has nowhere else to go. Fortunately for her, Riot does have their sights on reworking her among other champions, so maybe we might see another marksman jungler and Kindred won't be that lonely. But can we all just agree not to play Quinn in the top lane, please? No, I don't like playing Quinn, I hate ranged top laners so much. Alright anyways, if you enjoyed the video, a rating would be much appreciated, and if you'd like to see more content like this, consider subbing to the channel. Also check out the description down below for links to my Discord and social media, as well as a playlist containing all my Why No One Plays videos if you want to watch more. But that's it for today, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you again soon for the next one. Take care.